Good morning, children. Children, I welcome you all to this session of English literature. And we are concentrating on this session on Merchant of Venice, Act 3, Scene 1. And in that, it's the workbook work, which I will be detailing to you how to do it. Now, children, before I start on my deliberations, few things I would like to make very, very clear to you. That is, first of all, that your answers can differ from the answer which we are giving, but ICC board regards keywords to be very, very important, right? So the crux of the matter is keywords, and these keywords you will find in all these answers which I will be telling you. Once again, I am reiterating, these answers are not the complete answer, but they contain keywords, they contain guidelines, they contain the building blocks on which you can create your own answers. Now see, children, English literature, the marking pattern of ICC board is almost just like mathematics. If the question is of 3 marks, it needs to have 3 good solid key points, keywords into it, then you will get full upon full. If you are writing 1 page, 1.5 page, but the keywords are missing, then I'm sorry, you won't be getting good marks. Right? So these answers will give you some idea as to what points, what keywords you need to highlight in your answers. And you can recreate your own answers. Some of you might worry that, some might ask me a question that, sir, in this question, the answer, it does not have 2 sentence or 3 sentence. No problem. It is not sentence that matters. It is the keywords that matter. Right? So you can build up from them. You can divide them into 2-3 parts. You can add certain examples which you know. Additions or self-work is always, always rewarded in English literature. Right? We are not claiming that these answers are 100% complete, but they contain sizable number of keywords which can give you good marks. You need to elaborate these points, right? You need to elaborate these points. Now, Act 3, Scene 1, we all know where it occurred. It occurred in Venice, and there was a lot of confusion because prior to that, Jessica has eloped with Lorenzo, and Shylock is in utmost rage, and it's very, very angry, and he's looking for his daughter because his daughter has eloped, not only herself but along with lots of wealth, lot of money, right? So this is that scene where Celerine and Selenio torment a little bit of Shylock. I've also told during my deliberations that this scene Shakespeare had very, very carefully and meticulously placed to create a sort of break, a sort of interval to his key characters, which will be part and parcel of some huge speeches. In Act 3, Scene 2, you all know, Portia, Bassanio, the speeches are very, very long. So just to give them some rest, to give them some time to revise their text, so Shakespeare has very carefully placed this one. Now see the first one, how you should, this is the speech of Selenio. I would shiver as lying gossip. This was about the gossip, which discussion was going on between Selenio and Celerino. Now see the first question, whom does she refer to in the first line of the extract? What is said about her in the extract? So this question is having 2 parts, right? See, this is the part 1 here, and this is the part 2 here. First is, whom does she? Now this deserves a accurate answer, pinpointed answer, and see the answer here is, Dame Rumor has been personified as a woman in the extract and has been referred as she. So you will get 1 mark if you write Dame Rumor here, right? Now after that, what is said about her in the extract? When Celerino talks about Antonio's ship, Celerino wishes that the rumor may prove to be a big liar. Right? The first point is, it may prove to be a big liar. And how? As an old woman whose gossips with her neighbor over, her gingerbread calls and maid, right? So this is how you need to elaborate upon your answers, right? Let me see. Okay, now the next one, what was said about the place where the ship of Antonio was wrecked? Where did the news about the shipwreck spread? Right, see, again the question is divided into two parts. What was said earlier about the place where a ship of Antonio was wrecked? One part. Where did the news about the shipwreck spread? Earlier it was said that Antonio's ship was wrecked in the English Channel at Goodwin's, right? Goodwin Sands, a most perilous sandbank. The news about the shipwreck spread as at the Rialto or the Exchange, where merchant meets for business, right? So firstly, it was, first point is that it was said that the shipwreck has occurred, so you will get 1 mark for that. Now the next is about, the next part of it is about the Goodwin Sands and then Rialto. So these are the three key points in this answer which you need to write in your answer, right? Now see the third one. Without, give the meaning of without any slips of proximity or crossing the plain highway of talk. Now this is a very dicey kind of question. Give the meaning of, right? What we do is, see here, as in the workbook, the space is of just two lines, so an accurate answer has been written. You see here, the answer that has been mentioned here is, without any long-winded sentences or going outside the plain direct speech. That is all. Now imagine if this question comes to you in your exam. So it will come of how many marks? Minimum 3. So will you get, do you think you are going to get 3 marks for one line answer? Now how to write there is what you need to learn. Now here what you have, what you will be doing, you will be giving a small reference to the context that this line has been said by whom? It has been said by Salenio, right? To whom he is saying that? He is referring to Salarino, right? And they both are talking about the shipwreck which has occurred, whose news is spreading at the Rialto, right? Just a little outline, right? Just a little outline, and then you come to the answer, right? And then you come to the answer without any long-winded sentences. This is what actually Salenio meant by it, right? Don't just write this one line and imagine that the teacher is going to give you 3 marks. No way. We are going to give 3 marks for a little bit of reference to the context or a little bit of background. Similarly, it is for the fourth one. What feelings for Antonio are expressed by Salarino and Salenio in this extract? Salarino and Salenio are concerned and have sympathy for Antonio. See, this is first point, concerned and sympathy. Salenio calls him good Antonio, honest Antonio, to have an adjective worthy of being added to his name, right? So here you will find some keywords that are concerned and having sympathy for Antonio. Salenio calls him good Antonio, right? See, so concerned and sympathy is one of the keywords, then good Antonio and honest Antonio, and then the last one, have an adjective which best defines his name. So 3 keywords are there, and this answer is complete. You can divide it into 3 points. You can divide it. See, I've seen some students having an habit of writing the answer in a point-wise manner. That is also acceptable, provided points are there, keywords are there. Now we come to the last one. How does Shylock react to the loss of Antonio's ship? See, the first thing is, Shylock was pleased to hear about the loss of Antonio's ship. He calls him a bankrupt and a spendthrift, and then, and a beggar who used to come smiling to self-satisfied into the market. So lots of points are there. Right? You can divide it into separate sentences. Why was Shylock pleased? Then why did he call him bankrupt and spendthrift? Why did he call him a beggar? Right? So you can elaborate upon these points. Okay, let us move ahead. See, this is the second extract. Once again, a discussion. And here now, Shylock joins them. Right? Whose flight is being talked about? See, this is question one. Where has the person flown? Question two. With whom has the person flown? Question three. Three questions, 3 marks. That means this answer requires accurate answering. This question requires accurate answering. Whose flight is being talked about? They are talking about Jessica, who has flown to Belmont with Lorenzo. Where has the person flown? To Belmont. With whom has the person flown? Lorenzo. So these are the 3 points. Whose flight they are talking about? Jessica. Where has he flown? Belmont with Lorenzo. Now you can write it as a single sentence, and you can write it also as three divided answers. Right? Whose flight is being talked about? The flight being talked about is that of Jessica. Where has the person flown? The person Jessica being talked about has flown to Belmont. With whom has the person flown? She has flown there with Lorenzo. Right? You can divide your answer into 3 parts. Now, what bad news besides the flight of bird is given just before the arrival of Shylock? The news about the Antonio shipwreck in the English Channel at Goodwin Sands is being given before the arrival of Shylock. Right? Two concentrated answer is there. You can give a narrative. Who are talking? Where? What is this bad news all about? Who is discussing this and that? And then you can come to the point. Right? I'm sure you are clear with how to write, how to elaborate these answers, and you are clear about what kind of keywords you need to write in your answer, because unless and until these keywords are not there, you're not going to get marks. This is the ICC pattern. And in these answers, which I'm sending you along with this explanation, right, you will find primarily the focus being on the keywords, not on the length of the answer. Because, see, workbook has a limited space. When you are answering in the examinations, you can elaborate upon. But don't miss out these keywords. Okay? I hope that much is clear to you. So I stop here. Right? I will be sending you the complete answers of Act 3, Scene 1. So you can copy down in your workbook. Right? I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did in making it. And until we meet again, it's a goodbye.